It was cool that early September morning as the large doors of the convent home closed behind eight Sisters of Notre Dame de Namur. They climbed aboard two coaches that carried them 66 miles north to the port city of Antwerp. These missionary sisters were headed for America to establish the first Notre Dame schools in the New World, to teach the children, all of the children. They were traveling at the request of the American Bishop John Purcell, who had come to Namur a year earlier. He asked us to help him start schools in his new diocese, in America, in a place called Cincinnati. The crossing to the port of New York took 6 long weeks. It was another 14 days by canal boat, coach, and steamboat until our sisters finally reached Cincinnati. They weren't sure what to expect. Surely, they thought, this would be a wilderness populated by savages. They were astounded to find a bustling, civilized city of 45,000, with businesses and enterprise all along the riverfront. And they wasted no time in getting to work. Within 6 weeks, our sisters opened the first Notre Dame school in this country, right in the heart of the immigrant settlements. At the same time, these pioneer sisters set up a system to collaborate with the young Diocese of Cincinnati and began teaching in small parish schools around the city. What they created became a model for the Catholic school system in the Midwest and New England. They also held night classes for factory workers, opened industrial schools for children who had to leave school to work, and they built nurseries for working mothers. And they started schools for the hearing impaired and for the African American children in the city. Soon our Ohio sisters had started 17 Notre Dame schools around Cincinnati, 8 in Dayton, and 5 in Columbus. And we were teaching in another dozen schools in the state. Then in 1891, we were invited to come to Illinois, and we quickly opened parish schools in Liberty, Utica, Odell, Villa Park, and Calumet City. Finally, in 1926, we came to Chicago. Our first stop was St. Peter Canisius. Then we went to St. Robert Bellarmine. And in 1938, we opened our own Notre Dame High School for Girls on Mango Avenue. We've taught 3 generations of children in Chicago since then, and we still remember every one of them in our prayers and in our hearts. We will always be connected in some way.
The sisters here touched my heart in so many ways. I may not have known it then, but I know it now, and I love that they're part of my children's lives as well. I will never forget them. I love seeing them. I love being a part of them and thinking of them, and they will just always be a part of me and my family.
I'm not the only one that attended St. Robert Bellarmine. My siblings all attended as well. My older brother Rich was class of 1977. My sister Colleen, my younger sister, was 1982, and my brother Danny was 1985. So we all had the great good fortune of attending St. Robert Bellarmine together.
I sent my kids here because I had such a wonderful experience. I'm the oldest of 4, and all of my siblings came here as well, and I wanted my children to have the exact same experience we did. It was no question when it came to choosing a school.
I think about my children who graduated from here, went on to high school, did well, went on to college and did well. Then my grandchildren came along, and they've done very well here and gone on to high school and to college and done really good job. I mean, I have to credit, they started here. This is where it began.
I remember the time that my oldest daughter came home, Sister Leah, taught them how to do the capitals of every state with a song that they sang. All 4 of my kids know that song. So if you ask any one of my kids what the capital of any state is, they can tell you. They just have to sing the whole song to get to that state.
I am not the only alum in my family. My 2 sisters graduated from Notre Dame High School, and we also followed our mother who graduated from Notre Dame.
But I did enjoy math, and Sister Mary Lou was my 8th grade math teacher, and I went on to be a finance major in college and now in the financial sector and do insurance. And I really think Sister Mary Lou gave me a great base at St. Robert Bellarmine in math, my favorite subject.
I'm Jim Ryan, and all my five kids went to St. Robert's, and I've been blessed the day we walked in the front door.
I can tell the strong sense of community here. There's a lot of alums that send their children to this school. And to me, that's a very important, right? That shows a lot of how important and how much this school means to people here.
You know, when I think of the Sisters of Notre Dame, I think the lesson I learned most is actions speak louder than words. They really lead by example in a really quiet, spiritual, positive way. And I think just their hard work ethic and the presence and quiet strength that they gave the community is something that I really respected and to this day admire. It was really important to my mom to maintain the friendship with the sisters, and it's something that we've carried on, my siblings and I, and I get excited to talk to Sister Bridget and see Sister Mary Lou at some of the various luncheons, and I'm just really grateful for all they did and the education they helped give us all.
Over the course of 175 years in this country, our sisters have taught in 206 schools in 22 states, shaping the lives of millions of students. We also built Notre Dame University in Belmont, California, Emmanuel College in Boston, and Trinity College in Washington, D.C., to teach our next generation of leaders. And because we go where we are needed, our sisters have also begun schools in Brazil, China, Congo, Italy, Japan, Mexico, Kenya, Nigeria, Nicaragua, Peru, South Africa, and Zimbabwe. These days, we're needed in Haiti, in one of the largest and poorest neighborhoods in the city of Lakai. This is a place where there are no jobs for two-thirds of the labor force, where only half of the population can read and write, and where many children do not attend school because nearly all charge tuition that few parents can afford. This is where our sister Jeanette Pierre-Louise founded the Notre Dame Family Education Center. And with help from our Notre Dame AmeriCorps members, the struggling neighborhood has hope. It's coming from two micro-business classes Sister offers adults. One helps the women and men learn to make funeral wreaths. In another, they sew clothing. And in both, the adults are required to complete coursework in basic math, reading, and writing, all of which has helped to form a foundation for the women and men who've gone on to start their own businesses. Sister Jeanette's center also offers morning and afternoon literacy and math classes for the children who would otherwise be spending their days playing in the streets. Sister hopes one day to establish a scholarship program that will place some of the children in a formal school. Sister Jeanette's center is also home base for a group that is tackling malnutrition in Lakai. On 2 acres of fertile ground, a group of young men run a community garden. Their work provides for the people who visit Sister's Family Center. The gardeners also attend computer and English classes offered by Sister Jeanette's team. One of Sister's biggest dreams for the people of the neighborhood is becoming reality. It's a bakery, one that provides a quality product that the people need and can afford, and one that will become a trade school for bakers, something the country desperately needs. With help from our friends, we have been able to jumpstart that bakery, and together we are teaching the people of Haiti about business and hope. We are teachers, but our classrooms don't always come with four walls. Sisters of Notre Dame de Namur are also educators in a broader sense. We're published authors, parish educators, leaders in peace and justice, refugee resettlement, nursing home administration, pastoral counseling, liturgical planning and training, drug and alcohol rehabilitation, neighborhood development and law. We run daycare for children of working mothers, outreach centers for immigrant groups, English as a second language, and GED programs, prison ministries, visiting nursing services, and initiatives to stop human trafficking. And we have given our lives for the poor and abandoned in this world. We have always been a strong international congregation because we have been blessed with good friends who support our work, who continue to work alongside us today, friends who share our understanding of education as a basic human right, friends who believe, as we do, that opening classroom doors to all is our most powerful tool to reduce hunger and poverty, to spur economic growth, and to build peace. Friends who help us teach employment readiness programs for adults in the inner city and provide structured homes for women coming from prison. Friends who help us improve reading scores for little second graders. And friends who join with us to build bakeries a continent away. As we look to the future, we know we will go forward with smaller numbers of sisters. But the number of our friends is greater, and our congregation will continue to be just as strong, and our reach will be just as deep and wide as ever, because our work isn't finished. We have so much to do together in our next 175 years.